Welcome all. This is Dr. T. Jani Shubha, Associate Professor, Department of Chemistry, Rohini College of Engineering and Technology. Today's lecture topic is Environment and Human Health, which comes under the topic or title Human Population and Environment. So after completion of this topic, you will be able to conceptualize health in its physical, mental and social context, the physical, biological and psychosocial environment, and understand their impact on health. So now let us see the relation between environment and human health. As we all know, environment and human health are intricately related. A good environment is an indication of healthy human being and a developed nation. Now, polluted atmosphere has become a serious threat to the very existence of human species. Pollution growth and intensification of man's activities on various fronts like agriculture development, urbanization and industrialization all over the world have created a hazardous environment. The environment is under constant interface by human-bound activities. The effects of environment on human health are generally accounted in the following terms. First one is the extent to which environmental conditions lead to shortening of life. Second one is the extent to which environment-induced disability or impairment is found. And third one is the extent to which the biological potential of an individual is reduced. So now let us see the various environmental factors which affect human health. They are the overpopulation, pollution, urbanization and degradation of natural resources. Let us see in detail about each one of this. First one is overpopulation. It is population explosion, and this is the most important cause of all environmental problems. It leads to poverty, overexploitation of resources and environmental degradation. Next one is pollution. Any change in the environment which directly or indirectly affects the welfare of the human being is called pollution. This all we all know it very clearly. But air pollution, water pollution and solid waste pollution are of prime concern. Other kinds of pollution like nuclear hazards also cause problems related to health. So let us see about air pollution. The various pollutants present in the air directly affect the different systems of the body. These enter the human body by inhalation or absorption through skin or eyes. Next is water pollution. About 70% of the water bodies in India are polluted. Majority of Indian rivers are dangerously polluted. The common pollutants are the industrial effluents, municipality waste, agrochemicals, oil spills, etc. About 60% of waterborne diseases are reported in India. It includes typhoid, cholera, bacillary and amoebic dysentery, diarrhea and jaundice. The next comes the solid waste. The discharge of industrial sludges or dumping of industrial and municipal waste is a prime cause of land pollution. Such waste include garbage, rubbish, hospital refuse, dead animals, agriculture waste, etc. Again, the chemicals like pesticides, weedicides, insecticides, fungicides, etc. used in agriculture, food preservation, community health services, etc. Then, most of the pesticides are mutagenic and carcinogenic. Mutagens can cause chromosomal aberrations and various kinds of hereditary abnormalities. Now, let me show you certain chemicals which are hazardous to health. DDT can cause hepatocarcinoma, leukemia and aplastic anemia. The malathion, it causes schizophrenia and depression. And the deldrin, it causes insomnia. Then marathion, it causes muscular weakness and delayed paralysis. And the malathion, it damages liver and kidney. And also the hospital waste are the source of various infectious diseases, and these act as ideal home for disease carriers or vectors like flies, insects, bugs, rodents, etc. Heavy metals contaminated industrial effluents cause toxicities and various health problems such as fluorosis, Minamata disease, etc. So next reason for the human health issue is the urbanization. Increase in urbanization adversely affects the ecological balance It not only causes deforestation, but also increases uncontrolled discharge of municipal waste. Most Indian cities have about 40% population, which leads to deteriorating life quality and poor health services and flourishing of communicable diseases. These areas lack basic amenities and are disease prone. As such, the downtrodden areas of the cities are the prime sources of infectious diseases. Next is the degradation of natural resources. The loss of natural resources adversely affects the quality of human life. Example, the deforestation results in biodiversity loss because biodiversity is essential for maintaining the basic life supporting process. A number of medicines procured from various life forms are essential for human health. Let us conclude it. As such, clean and green environment is the life of life. A time to take corrective steps is still there if taken care of. Now, a new concept of development is needed that emphasizes the relation between human beings and nature. A sustainable development is the only solution to save human life and health. And after this, listening to this video lecture, you can answer to the question, throw light on the interlink between environment and human health. Hope you all enjoyed this video. Thanks for watching and don't forget to like and subscribe. Thank you.